Let me just get situated here, fam. If I told you one time, I told you one time. I've never told a joke in my life. I'm a simple man trying to motivate the people. I believe I do a good job at it, fam. The set you're gonna watch was July 28th, 2022, in the year of our Lord, praise Him. The people I felt were in need of me, and I don't know if we've ever had a people reaction like the one that we got on this film, which we almost didn't record. I hope you enjoy it as much as I hope delivering it. Take it away.
All right, guys. So your first comic, I found him in Harlem, New York. And he was doing something strange. I didn't know what the fuck was going on. The first time I saw him, I was like, yo, what is he doing? And then the second time I saw him, I was like, yo, he's doing something. And the third time I saw him, I was like, yo, this nigga's a genius. All right, guys, give it up for your very next comic, George Hayward.
Popeye's chicken. Please give it up for George John Jordan Thomas Aquinas Hayward Optimus.
Thank you.
Please be seated. You are seated. Fantastic. Now I say this with not a shred of arrogance, fam, but in Soho, at the Soho Playhouse, I am a man who needs no introduction. Because I am the president of the New York City chapter of the Cancel Valentine's Day Movement. Fam, we are going to get there. You may not be aware of this, but February is right around the corner, and we cannot have this day. Many New Yorkers don't understand the importance of the months that I am talking about. So I will demonstrate to you tonight the importance of canceling Valentine's Day. Clap once if you are single. I am also single. Which makes Valentine's Day, fam, a depressing day. If I may, I would like to take a brief sojourn for my prepared remarks. I would like to briefly address the single ladies. Single ladies. I am available, and I offer you two things. Number one, what you want. And number two, what you need. You can now and then know at GeorgeHaywardDates@AOL.com. You right now because I'm on stage motivating the people. Yes. But when I return to my apartment, I will answer you as soon as it is possible for me to do. If you do not hear from me, check your spam folders, fam. I may be in there. I would like to get back to canceling Valentine's Day at this point of our discussion. Clap your hands if you are a player. Excuse me for a second. Matt, I'm okay. Who clapped the hands?
This guy did.
Okay. I have to do this. The number one rule of being a player is that you do not admit you're a player, fam. In my legal practice, I deal with many people like this man. I will give you an example. Just this week, I'm going to call her Katie, I'm going to call him Jim. Jim found himself a very hot water, fam, because Katie found panties that she alleges were not hers in her bedroom. That's what he had to call me in, fam. I said, Katie, Jim, a gainfully employed man who calls his mother three times a week, will be exercising his Fifth Amendment right against self-incrimination. Your Honor, he will not be answering any more questions. In fact, in our country, the burden is on the plaintiff, fam. You have to show me beyond any reasonable doubt. These panties, they are fair, let me be honest, man. I'm feeling a lot of reasonable doubt. No further questions. This entire thing could have been prevented if he didn't say he was a player. Katie, those can't be any other panties. I'm not a player. Done. I would like to get back to what I was trying to say, canceling Valentine's Day. Clap your hands once if you are in a loving relationship. Woo! I'm happy for you, I really am. I'm not jealous. The fact that you have love, emotional support, great sex, that don't bother me personally. But why do we all have to be roped in to your day? If only there were a day for you. Oh, anniversary, fam. Every day should be Valentine's Day to you. I'm open up with you. I'm opening up with that. I'm opening up with them. I don't usually say this, but the last time I celebrated Valentine's Day when I was called to the movement was a couple years ago. And I invited one of my biggest crushes over. And first we did some talking that led to the wine. And then we drank some wine and that led to the couch. And then we put on a little TV. And I put in the ISIS documentary. And right when I was about to kiss her, fam, it cut to ISIS crucifying a man. These people are barbarians. She walked out of my apartment. She walked out of my life. Fuck Valentine's Day. I didn't have my first kiss till I was 20 years old. That's why I love Pete Davidson. In the New York comedy world, I was the first to defend Pete Davidson. Because I love that he had the confidence to go get what he wanted. I told the comedians in New York City, this is really what I said. I said, when Pete eats, we all. I said, when Pete cooks him, we all fuck him. I didn't have my first kiss until I was 20 years old. Because I had a medical condition called being fat, fam. I didn't lose the weight till I obtained swine flu in 2009, fam. Didn't have a first kiss till 20 years old. Well, Joke's on you, ladies. That's why many of you cannot achieve orgasms. Because you date these skinny men who count calories when they eat your pussy. Why don't you date a fat man who brings a placemat when he eats the pussy? Praise him, fam. Do you want a snack, a magazine? Text me if you need anything. I'll be down here doing the Lord's work. Wise comment once told me some men fuck to come, but other men come to fuck. Love Pete Davidson because he had the confidence, fam. I used to say sex is like good credit. I don't have good credit. But my mother, she saw me, she said, young son, if you don't believe in your cock, son, then neither will she. Fam, that was the wisest thing I ever heard. First came the confidence, then came the swagger, and now I say sex is like bad credit. That mean I don't have to pay y'all anymore. Praise. Praise. We still overthink things. When I'm out motivating, people ask me, does size matter? Because people will tell you it doesn't, but it seems like every woman I meet want a man who's 6 feet. Bam. The only man I know with a 6 foot penis is my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
May the church say amen. May the church. Amen. You know I speak the truth. Because in every porno that I watch, what do they say? Jesus Christ, that's a big dick. This ain't about Jesus. My name is George John Jordan Thomas Aquinas Hayward, the fried chicken man, the good optimist, the cool breeze Tony Sparks called the black Justin Bieber. I came here to speak tonight. Don't tell me you my friend if you don't know those six names. Don't tell me you woke if you can't spell Kaepernick. Don't tell me you know stress if you've never tried stand up. Don't tell me you know swagger if you've never met Obama. Thank you. One voice can change a room, and one room can change a state. And I want you to listen to this young brother, George Hayward. He's going to motivate you tonight. Thank you. Don't tell me you know awkward if you never bust a nut on the dance floor, fam. I said, don't tell me you know awkward if you never bust a nut putting on the condom. I said, don't tell me you know awkward if you've never bust a nut just because you met her father. I can't hear. The father is stressful. and stress can have physical effects. Stress can make you miss your period, fam. But when you are in here, fam, you are under my protection. You are my congregation. And we are going to have a good time one way or the other. I came here to motivate tonight, fam. On the other side of that door is your ex, your landlord, your in-law, your debt collector, your other debt collector, your other debt collector, your auditor, the asshole at the office who won't leave you alone. But fam, that only makes me more passionate because I believe the people are in need of motivation. When I was asked to come down to Soho House to tell jokes, I've never been more offended in my life, fam. I have never told a joke in my life. I am a simple man who has tried his best to motivate the people, and if I had seen something today, the people are in need of motivation. These bosses keep asking us for more work. What's up with that? These landlords keep asking us for more rent. What's up with that? Mm-hmm. These girlfriends keep asking us, is it in yet? What's up with that? The people are in need of motivation. Now the management is telling me that my remarks must draw soon to a close, fam. I was just beginning. But I will tell you this, fam. We need stand-up comedy because it helps us answer the hardest questions in life. As a lead motivator in this city, I am tasked routinely with grappling with these questions. Why are we here? What is the meaning of life? What is Victoria's Secret, fam? They not gonna tell us? They not gonna let us know? Why they call her the Virgin Mary? But they don't call him the Virgin Jesus, fam. What would have happened, fam, if Sarah got the one ring? Would we even have Soho Playhouse? Would we even have stand-up comedy? Would we all be orcs? How do you print to PDF, fam?
All right. I told you. I fucking told you, didn't I? I told you. I said it at first. You're not going to know what the fuck is happening. And then you're going to be like, something's happening. And then you're going to be fucking laughing. The guy's a fucking genius. Every time I see him, he gets better. I don't know how he does it. I love it. George Hayward, everybody.
Yo, perfect, dog. Killed that shit on the fly, on the street. Just kind of a moment on the street. Fam, I will never forget that night. It was a motivational pandemonium. And the people were not satisfied with the motivation as it was. In fact, they wanted more, fam. They wanted rap. And on this night, they would not be denied. I think we should roll this tape as well. Let's cut it.
It is stand-up. What is he standing up about?
Can
he rap?
Yeah.
I have to hear noise about it. If you want to rap, all right. What is he rapping about? Blue Dolphins.
I don't.
Everyone keeps saying there's nothing there. There's nothing there. This is a dead end premise.
Halloween.
Halloween. Rapper Halloween.
Yeah, that's a good one. Halloween.
Fam. People ask me what I should be for Halloween, fam. I always say I be myself. Because it's so hard to be yourself these days. Hit me with this beat, give me more. G, E, O to the R, G to the E, that boy will treat you far. Like him on the left, like him on the right, give him what it takes, he don't know where to fight, fam. He educate, he tolerate. Yes, he's straight. Yeah, here. The yellow thing that is his biz. I could go forever. That's my name, no matter the weather. July 29th, that's my birthday. I am glad to be here. It's the birthday. One minute, that's what she said. I was right there in the bed. How many minutes? I'm not a microwave. I'm not a microwave. How many minutes to the Uber come for you? Uber come for you. Leave, please. It's my birthday, I can do a bit. It's my birthday, I can do a jig. It's my birthday, I can get a number. George Hayward, date, app, and wild.com, fam, baby.
Thank you all for coming for this way too long show. We're figuring out how to make it shorter. We're gonna do it, guys.
Oh, I love it!
Yeah, so I'll never do that again. but big thanks to the Soho Playhouse and Matt. Thanks for watching. God bless. Lord always delivers. I'll be catching you.
Singing something like this. Listen here. Oh, beautiful, far spacious skies, far amber waves of grain, far purple mountain majesties.
And the fried chicken man say the Lord always delivers, cause he has delivered for the fried chicken man. Thanks for watching, fam. Lord still delivers.